5 essential Paris, France travel tips. But before we start, we want you to hit that red subscribe button so that you never miss out on any of our videos. So, are you thinking of having to Paris for the first time, the fifth time, or the thousandth time? Well, I'm sure that there are plenty of things you may well not have considered, but that you totally need to know. From the best time to visit the city to exploring off the beaten path, here are some Paris travel tips you need to know before visiting. So make sure to watch the video till the end. The best time to visit Paris is in the shoulder seasons.
Welcome to Paris.
Is it always like this?
Yes.
Always.
Always.
Oh, yes, man, what is this?
So guys, the first and the topmost tip I would recommend to you is that the best time to go to Paris is just before or just after peak season, summer. This way, you'll still be able to get the good weather, albeit without as many of the crowds that inevitably visit during the warmer months of the year. Spring and autumn also provide perfect photo opportunities with cherry blossom season in April and fall, foliage spotting in October and November. Visit outside of peak season and you can also expect to find fewer queues and invariably lower prices when it comes to plane fares and accommodation. Plan your accommodation well in advance and stay in a central location. Only book your accommodation close to the airport if you're getting a flight early the next morning, and only then for that night only. When it comes to your Paris visit, accommodation is going to be a large portion, if not the largest allocation, of your travel budget. As such, I highly recommend booking your stay well in advance, and choosing a place to stay in Paris is dependent entirely on your own personal travel preferences.
Stand / dinner table. Yeah, you heard that right. Or the studio, because it just...
Thought it'd be really cool to share with you guys like the typical living space for like students and au pairs that live in central Paris.
Most of the luxury hotels can be found in the 8th arrondissement of the city, while more budget locations can be found near the peripheric. Otherwise, if you're looking to get a local's perspective on the city and don't feel like dining out every night, then you might consider booking an apartment on Airbnb.
Habiter à Paris.
Oui.
Oui.
Absolument.
Et pourquoi?
Quelques mois pour mes études et j'aime vraiment énormément l'offre culturelle et il y a tellement de choses qui se passent tout le temps.
From luxurious studio offering views of the Eiffel Tower to budget rooms, there's something for every price range. Beware of pickpockets. So guys, be cautious on the metro. Keep your bag in your hands and tucked into your body, not hanging on the crook of your arm or on your back and near tourist attractions. One popular scam to be aware of is when someone, usually a young person, asks you to sign a petition and then demands money. Homelessness and begging are also commonplace in Paris, and while the people are mostly harmless, you won't be able to help everyone without going broke.
Where are you from, mister?
Bawari.
Redance. Where are you from, mister?
Senegal. Yes, speak French in Senegal.
Yes,
Spain.
Do you speak French?
No, sorry.
Throughout Paris, you'll likely come across a variety of scams, especially if you're largely frequenting touristic areas around Montmartre, Hotel de Ville, and Le Marais. These range from someone asking you to sign a fake petition to people trying to tie a string around your hands. Likewise, always keep an eye on your belongings, especially in places like the metro, as pickpocketing is fairly common. Always use a bag with a zip and never wear a backpack on your back. And even then, don't leave your wallet or valuables near the top of your bag. Best city to be explored on foot. Guys, like many European capital cities, Paris is a place best explored on foot. Prepare to walk plenty. After all, I often find that it's only when I'm wandering around Paris that I truly get a...
Oui, j'habite à Paris. Pourquoi? Vous habitez à Paris et pas dans une autre ville?
Ce que j'y travaille?
Get a feel for the authentic Paris and see the settlement from a local's perspective.
Je la trouve particulièrement belle. Saison et quelle que soit l'heure du jour, je trouve qu'il y a toujours une lumière exceptionnelle. La plupart des bâtiments sont très beaux et puis les quartiers sont complètement différents.
This way, you'll also get the opportunity to peek behind those doorways and discover the hidden gems you might have otherwise missed if you were on a bus or standing on the metro. Expect things in Paris to be closed on a Sunday. As in many predominantly Catholic countries, many things are closed for business on a Sunday, or at the very least, operate under limited hours. As such, if you need to purchase some supplies from the supermarket or the like, be sure to buy these well in advance. Head to the countryside and you can expect to find that even many of the bars and restaurants will be closed on Sunday. With this being said, most major museums as well as attractions like the Eiffel Tower and the Arc de Triomphe remain open on Sundays. Museums such as the Louvre and Musée d'Orsay are typically closed on Mondays or Tuesdays instead. And so guys, that's all for today. I hope you liked the video. If you did, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel so that you never miss any amazing videos from us.